escuchar Cadenas sonando.
Hola amigos, ¿cómo están? This is Señora Baez with another class of Clase de Español con Señora Baez. ¡Feliz Navidad! I hope everybody has had a good Christmas time so far. Today, we're going to go over our vocabulary words first and talk about them in context, using them in sentences. We have some pretty fun videos and discussions today. Let's repeat after Señora Baez. Árbol navideño. Árbol navideño. Christmas tree. Cascabel or campana. Bell. Pascuas. Poinsettia. How do we say poinsettia in Spanish? Think about last week's story. I read the legend of the poinsettia to you guys, and at the end of the story, they call it something. I'm going to read it again so we can practice. So in the story, at the end, it says, here, let me make my camera bigger. There we go. It says, and every Christmas to this day, the red stars shine on top of green branches in Mexico. The people call the plants la flor de Nochebuena, the flower of the holy night, the poinsettia. I'm going to read that one more time. La flor de Nochebuena. Nochebuena is the night before Christmas, so that is Christmas Eve. So they call it the flower of Christmas Eve, or the holy night is Christmas Eve as well. So Nochebuena means Christmas Eve. And how do we say Christmas Day? We say Día de Navidad. Día de Navidad. So I want you guys to think about what day it is. Today, for me, we have 16 days left for Christmas. 16 días. So I want you guys to look at the calendar, see how many days you have, and try to remember how to say that number in Spanish. So going back to what we were talking about, how do we say poinsettia in Spanish? We call it la flor de Nochebuena, or the flower of the holy night. Regalos. Regalos. Say the word. Regalos are gifts. ¿Cuántos regalos hay? How many gifts are there? Vamos a contar. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Cuatro regalos. Four gifts. Nieve. Nieve means snow. Copos de nieve. Copos de nieve. Snowflakes. Los copos de nieve se derriten. Los copos de nieve se derriten. These snowflakes are melting. Las bolas de nieve. Las bolas de nieve. Snowballs. Botas. Boots. Botas. Boots. Las botas me calientan los pies. The boots keep my feet warm. El gorro. El gorro es para mi cabeza fría. It's for a cold-headed person. Mi cabeza fría. El gorro de Papá Noel es rojo. El gorro de Papá Noel es rojo. What color is Santa Claus's hat? Rojo, red. Mi gorro es azul y blanco. Mi gorro es azul y blanco. My hat is blue and white. El sombrero. El sombrero is a regular hat or a top hat. El trineo. El trineo is a sled. La bufanda. La bufanda. A scarf. La bufanda es roja. La bufanda es roja. The scarf is red. La bufanda es suave. La bufanda es suave. The scarf is soft. La corbata. La corbata. The tie. Los guantes. Los guantes. Gloves. La chaqueta. La chaqueta. The jacket. Muñeco de nieve. Muñeco de nieve. Snowman. El reno. El reno. A reindeer. Rodolfo el reno. Rudolph. Santa Claus o Papá Noel is Santa Claus. Casa de jengibre. Casa de jengibre is gingerbread house. ¿La casa de jengibre está completa o incompleta? La casa no tiene techo. It does not have a roof. Therefore, por eso, la casa está incompleta. It's not finished. Hombre de jengibre. Hombre de jengibre. So I found a video about the gingerbread man from Shrek, and I'm going to play it. But first, I'm going to play part of this video. It's a really famous Spanish children's song. It's called Ping Pong es un muñeco. Ping Pong is a doll, and he's made out of cardboard, and he washes his face with soap and water. I don't know where the song started, but it's kind of funny. So I'm going to play this one, and then I'll play the other one so you know what it's talking about. Just stay with me here. Okay, so that's Ping Pong. He washes his face, he uses a comb. You saw it, you know what I'm talking about. So, now I'm going to play the video of Shrek when Lord Farquaad is bullying the gingerbread cookie to get him to give him information. Let's see. He said, that's enough. I'm ready.
Corre, 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 que nadie te pueda alcanzar. No me podrás atrapar. Soy el hombre de jengibre.
Eres un monstruo.
El único monstruo aquí eres tú. Tú y esos personajes de cuentos de hadas que arruinan mi mundo perfecto.
So he said, you're a monster, and he told the gingerbread cookie, Lord Farquaad, the only monsters are you and your fairy tale friends who ruin my perfect world. Now tell me, where are they?
He said, no. Pero mi paciencia ha llegado a su límite. Dime o te arrancaré.
No, los botones no, no mis botones.
Don't tear my buttons.
De acuerdo, te lo cuento. Tú conoces a Ping-Pong.
¿Ping-Pong?
Sí, Ping-Pong.
Sí, es un muñeco muy guapo y de cartón.
Sí.
Se lava su carita con
agua y con jabón.
¿Con agua y con jabón?
Sí, se lava la carita.
Se lava la carita con agua y con jabón. Milord, lo encontramos. Y...
Okay, so in Shrek they reference that the English version says the Muffin Man, but I thought this one was funnier. So, they gingerbread cookie and Lord Farquaad talk about Ping Pong to distract him from bullying him. Okay, let's keep going. Caramelo, candy cane. Caramelo is candy cane. ¿De qué color es el caramelo? What color is the candy cane? ¿De qué color es el caramelo? We have azul y negro. Is it black and blue? No. Rojo y amarillo. Is it red and yellow? No. Verde y anaranjado. Is it green and orange? No. Blanco y rojo. Is it red and white? Sí. El caramelo es blanco y rojo. ¿De qué color es el caramelo? Well, ¿de qué color es el caramelo? ¿Es rojo? Sí o no. Si es rojo, it has red. ¿Anaranjado? Sí o no. No hay anaranjado. ¿Morado? Sí o no. No hay morado. ¿Azul? Sí o no. No hay azul. ¿Verde? Sí o no. Si hay verde, blanco. Si hay blanco, amarillo. sí hay amarillo. So total is amarillo, blanco, verde, azul, rojo. El duende is the elf. Luces de Navidad. Say it with me. Luces de Navidad. Christmas lights. Okay, which one is luces de Navidad? This one or this one? This one, the Christmas lights. Okay. Olaf y Frosty. Now I'm going to read a quick short story about Olaf and Frosty. Okay, so here is the story about Olaf and Frosty. Hay dos muñecos de nieve. Hay dos muñecos de nieve. There are two snowmen. El grande se llama Frosty. The big one is called Frosty. El pequeño se llama Olaf. The small one's called Olaf. Frosty tiene un sombrero negro, una bufanda azul, unos guantes azules y rojos. Sorry, una bufanda azul y roja and unos guantes azules y rojos. Olaf tiene frío. How's Olaf feeling? He's feeling cold. Olaf no tiene ni sombrero, ni bufanda, ni guantes. Pobrecito Olaf. He does not have a hat or a scarf or gloves. Poor Olaf. Frosty le da un gorro a Olaf. Frosty gives Olaf a hat. Frosty le da un gorro a Olaf. El gorro es muy grande. The hat is too big. Olaf todavía tiene frío. Frosty le da unos guantes. Olaf is still cold, so Frosty gives him gloves. Los guantes son muy grandes. The gloves are too big. Olaf todavía tiene frío, so he's still cold. Frosty le da una bufanda roja y blanca. La bufanda es muy larga. It is very long. Olaf tiene mucho calor. He feels like he's melting. Frosty le da a Olaf un sombrero nuevo, una bufanda más corta y unos guantes más pequeños. Más pequeños. So he gets a new hat, a shorter scarf, and smaller gloves. Olaf está contento. So Olaf feels happy. The end. I hope you enjoyed it. Okay, now I'm going to play a video. It was filmed in Puerto Rico, but it's not really about Puerto Rico. It's about Christmas and what it means to Spanish speakers and Latin Americans. A lot of people have like a very religious take on it. They love to go to church and do the processions, like in the story we read about the poinsettia. But this one has more of like a sharing family type of theme. So I'm going to play it and just let me know what you think.
Nuestra gente,
nuestra gente.
Ambos, luces, se apagan las luces, se encienden las luces, mejor la ciudad. Vamos a celebrar el día que llegó la Navidad. Vamos a celebrar que viene la felicidad. Vamos a celebrar el día que llegó la Navidad. El pelaje de ayer lloramos, pero no levantamos. Puerto Rico es Puerto Rico, a donde voy siempre lo explico. Son las mejores navidades, si no me crees, date un palo de coquito.
La Navidad es
un
marca del mundo, la Navidad es más linda del mundo, la Navidad es más larga del mundo, la tenemos acá. La Navidad es más larga del mundo.
To review the stuff that I kind of introduced last week. So in Mexico, imagine you're in Mexico. Right now they're celebrating Las Posadas. Las Posadas. This is their Christmas celebration. They go from house to house to remember Mary and Joseph, who went from home to home asking for shelter. They sing Christmas carols, and at the end of the night, everyone shares hot chocolate and punch, and the children try to get candy out of the piñata. So I am going to play a quick little video about Las Posadas.
Hey, bro, what were you looking at on your phone while we were playing basketball?
I got a message from my cousin. He sent me a picture of him in his robe getting ready for Las Posadas.
Las Posadas? What is that?
Las Posadas is a way of celebrating in many cities in Mexico, Frankie.
I have never heard of Las Posadas before.
Frankie, in English, Las Posadas means the inn, and it is a festival that honors the journey of Joseph and Mary from Nazareth to Bethlehem in a search of safe place where Mary could give birth to baby Jesus.
Do they celebrate it on Christmas Day, like many other people around the world, on December 25th?
Actually, it is celebrated from December 16th through December 24th. Each night during the festival, a child dresses like an angel, and everyone follows him in something called a procession. Other kids are there dressed in silver and gold robes, carrying lit candles and pictures of Joseph and Mary riding her donkey while they visit selected homes asking for a place to stay. People in the homes tell them no, and the procession keeps going.
So is it just the kids who take part in the festival?
No, adults take part too. For example, they play music as they make their way and read scripture at each stop from the Bible, and they also sing Christmas carols.
Do they do anything else?
Yes. At the end of the evening, they have mass, and the kids break open piñatas that are filled with candy, toys, and more.
Bro, I love how people celebrate the holidays around the world, and this was fun learning about Las Posadas for kids.
And I hope you had fun learning with FRESPERG. Cartoon.
So the next one we talked about last week was the tradition in Spain. In Spain, they have a huge lottery that goes up to a few million dollar euros, not dollars. And every year they make a really iconic commercial for everybody to watch to like tug at your heartstrings and get you to buy a ticket and give it as a gift and stuff for the lottery. So I'm going to play that next. This is the commercial for 2020.
Cuídate.
Marina, quería compartir este décimo contigo. Este año ha habido momentos en los que he sentido miedo, pero gracias a ti, nunca me he sentido sola.
So, the neighbor put a letter underneath her door and it says, this year we've been scared and it's been hard times, but I've never felt alone. So she turns around as she is reading it.
Carmen.
So she can't hug her because of COVID, but they're saying share like you never have. So that's a good message for people to go out in 2020 and Christmas to remember that compartir como nunca, share like you never have. So find ways to share with your friends and your family. And el sorteo que nos une means the lottery or the raffle that unites us, that makes us one. So that is all for La Lotería, the Spain's tradition. So now, tradición navideña from Puerto Rico, or the Puerto Rican tradition, is parrandas. So these are like Christmas carols, but they're a lot more like lively. It's like a party. There's a lot of percussion instruments and a lot of like really loud singing and guitar. And I'm going to play a video so you guys can see how they did a parranda in the Bronx. And I thought that part about the... Okay, so now we're going to talk about Christmas in Bolivia. Christmas in Bolivia. La Navidad en Bolivia. En el 24 de diciembre, on Christmas Eve, muchas personas van a la Misa de Gallo. Many people go to the Mass of the Rooster or Nochebuena Mass. Nochebuena is the night before Christmas, and they go to Mass early in the night. It's a Bolivian tradition to bring two small presents to the midnight mass, similar to what we saw in The Legend of the Poinsettia. A figurine of Niño Manuelito, or Baby Jesus, and another representing their trade or profession. So a banker might bring a loaf of bread, and a cobbler might bring a new pair of shoes. Along with the Jesus figurine, both in the offering as an appeal for abundance in the new year. Después de la misa, familias comen una cena grande. After Mass, they go eat a really large dinner. Christmas picana is a traditional Christmas meal. It's a sopa especial, a special soup, con varias carnes, with many several meats, such as lamb, beef, chicken, and vegetables, squash, and corn. Refresco, or cold fruit drink, or like a soda, and it comes with roast pork or beef or a variety of fruits and salad. This is something that they do on Christmas as well, is fuegos artificiales, fireworks. On Christmas morning, what's typical is for la mañana, in the morning, comer buñuelos y chocolate caliente, to eat donut holes and hot chocolate. Uno, se celebran el summer solstice. They give Pachamaman, or Mother Earth, a thank you for harvesting and prosperous year to come. And a very important thing throughout Latin America during Christmas is the nativity scene. Families will decorate nativity scenes in and outside of their homes. This seems to be more popular than decorating trees and lights. However, in the bigger cities, there are Christmas trees and lights that are used too. Okay, that is all. After Christmas break, I'm gonna go over the Three Kings Day, or the Three Wise Men Day, that many countries celebrate, and I will read a story about it too. So we're going to stop there for all of our culture lessons for Navidad. I hope you guys learned a lot today. We're gonna go over just a few more words and wrap it up. So to wrap the lesson up, we're going to answer this question. ¿Qué aprendiste? What did you learn today? We may have learned something that had to do more with like the meaning of Christmas in Latin America. What are some symbols? For example, there's a lot of symbols across the countries about unity and family, spending time with loved ones, giving time, giving love, giving through presents like the lottery. Or you may have learned words because we went over our snowman words and some of our Christmas vocab words. So let's review just three main ones that I want you guys to remember. Muñeco de nieve means snowman. This particular snowman is wearing a sombrero, a bufanda, and he has three botones. So he's wearing a hat, scarf, and he has three buttons. Feliz Navidad. And I hope you guys have a Feliz Navidad. That's why I am putting that one on there. And just try to enjoy the time and relax. And Papá Noel. Papá Noel means Santa Claus. And although in some countries in Latin America, the tradition is not as big here, Papá Noel is a very important part of Navidad. I hope everybody has a wonderful rest of their week. I love you guys so much. Los quiero mucho. Adiós.